Once upon a time, I used to talk about Star Trek ships on here, and I really loved doing it. Why it's taken me over 7 years to do another one, I have absolutely no idea. Hey guys and gals, I'm here with Vito. Today we're looking at Playmates' Deep Space Nine station. I was called a playset. It's not really a playset. All the way back from 1994. So, if you don't want to see the packaging, if you don't want to see the paperwork inside, I've got chapters down below. You can skip straight ahead wherever you want. I don't focus on packaging very often, but if it's something this old, I feel like it's worth it. I feel like, because it's just, there's something great about the artwork. The fact that you don't have this kind of stuff today, and I'm gonna get the light out of there. I love the packaging from the old Star Trek toys. They all have their little Collector's Edition number on there. It says it's supposed to have a certificate of authenticity inside. I don't recall ever having one of those, so I don't know if it means that. I don't know. But there's just something great about these vintage 90s kind of boxes. You got Deep Space Nine, you got the Enterprise D, you got the wormhole at the top. It's great. So you go around to the back here, and that shows you everything that you have included, everything you can play with. A neat thing is apparently there was a contest to design an alien to appear in Deep Space Nine. I can cover more of that in a little bit, but yeah, there's everything you get. If you do want to read the back, I'll leave it there. You can pause your video, read it, do whatever you like. Just don't tell me about it. There you go. So I bought my Deep Space Nine many, many years ago, and I was surprised to find that the paperwork was still included. So, of course, you have your directions, and I love how all this is laid out. They actually call things by their technical names. You can see here you have the light up docking sail towers, docking ports, upper docking platform, defense shield generator. You have the ops tower, the habitat ring. Everything is just laid out, and it's a cute little thing to have. I like it. Just like on the Star Trek DS9 TV show, you can dock the miniature Starship Enterprise at the upper pylon docking port by fitting the hole underneath the Enterprise's saucer section to the docking post. See the close-up diagram C. That's diagram C. So little things like that are just a fun touch. Also, it comes with technical blueprints, which, like, you don't get this anymore. This doesn't really get like a full view of DS9, but you get a nice little look. You see the docking clamps, small dock, docking ring, power transfer conduit, exhaust core, fusion power plant, kind of little things that maybe you didn't know about DS9. I know I didn't know a lot of what those were named, and I've seen the show. So yeah, a cute little thing to have. But enough about that. Let's get on to the real prize. I want to win this contest. I want to design an alien to be on Deep Space Nine. The first prize, you get $500. Second prize, you get the action figure collection from Deep Space Nine. And then you can also get a shirt. They made an alien out of me. Like, I want to enter this. I want to win it. So I'm going to fill this out, send it in. There's my alien profile. And hopefully I'll win. So if you are looking to buy a Deep Space Nine off eBay, of course you're going to need the full station, which I'm going to scoot you guys a teensy bit closer. You're kind of caught on my light. There we go. Hopefully that'll be fine. There should be six docking pylons included. Three for the top, three for the bottom. They are different. If you go, the ones on the top, the best way to tell is to line them up. They look basically identical except for this little tab at the bottom. The longer ones are the top, shorter ones are the bottom. So make sure you have your three of those. Well, your six of those. There are three of each. You got a little mini Enterprise D that you can dock. You got your shield generator, which goes right onto there. You have your ops tower, which I have tried to get these guys straight so many times, and it's just not gonna happen. The plastic's just way too bendy. So that's just gonna go around there, plug everything in. Also, it takes three batteries, so there are three battery doors. They are on each side there. Make sure there's no corrosion inside. Make sure you have all three doors. And yeah, so assembling it is very, 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 have I said very too many times? Very easy. You just take your little pylons, they clamp in there. And you know what? I think I actually grabbed one of the wrong ones. You can tell because the shorter ones don't fill in that gap entirely. I think I got them all mixed up as I was shuffling through them. So let's try that one. There you go. That's how it should look. That's the only way to really tell that you're doing it right or wrong, is if I totally got them mixed up, is if you have that full section filled in. So are you going to be a good boy? You're a good boy. There you go. So now this shouldn't be a problem. Everything should be the same. They fit in very easily. The bottom ones don't really lock in place as well as the top ones. They are really just friction only. And I've had one kind of pop out every now and then. But there is that. The final piece of the puzzle is, of course, the display stand. With this, you can actually rotate DS9. I think you will see this very clearly later on. That's just really what it looks like. It's just slightly detailed. There's not too much paint applications on it. But you take your Deep Space Nine, rest it onto there. It kind of plugs in. And there you go. So the whole thing is, of course, it's on a stand. The box even advertises a feature, a unique rotating stand. And I'm kind of wondering if I should loop it up because sometimes the stand kind of moves with it. But right now we're doing okay. So you can just rotate Deep Space Nine. It would be really cool if you could rig up some kind of motor inside to rotate it automatically, just kind of have it just go on its own. But this is a really nice display piece. I tried to review this so many times when I first got it, but I hadn't seen Deep Space Nine yet, so it just, I didn't have the passion for it. I'm a weirdo who likes Voyager, but Deep Space Nine is fun as well. And the detail on this is what you would expect from Playmates. It's not heavily detailed like the Diamond Select stuff was, but keep in mind, this is, what, a 27-year-old toy now? I think for its time, they did a really good job sculpting details. The Ops Tower has little windows all along the sides. The shield generator does spin. And I think everything just looks really nice. I like the little gold details. And I just, it's great to have this in my display. Let's put it back on there. It, of course, comes with a little Enterprise D. And for those of you who have this, what is a decent scale for other starships that I could get to fit this? Because I want to say Eagle Moss, but I don't want to modify those. I would love to get some more starships and just kind of like maybe get some kind of clear twist ties and have as if it's just ships flying by. It does come with a little Enterprise D. There are two little holes at the bottom that you can put onto the docking pylon at the top there. If I can get it lined up, it's kind of hard to see. It's in the shadow right now. We're in the shadows. This is taking way much longer than it should. The shadows. There we go. Just kind of get it on there. And there you go. I would have loved if we could have a Defiant to go with this, but I'm assuming when this came out, the Defiant wasn't in the show yet. That's what I'm kind of guessing. Maybe when they first designed this, it was based off the first episode because the Enterprise does dock on Deep Space Nine. That's what starts the entire show. But it would be great to have more ships with this. I would love a Defiant. A Defiant would be ideal. I don't care if I have to modify this so I can add a new docking port. And if it's an Eagle Moss, I don't want to have to drill a hole just to put a little place in there. I don't know. Just let me know. Like, it would be great if someone who 3D prints could design additional starships of this scale. So you have a really nice little display. So this is a Playmate Star Trek ship. It does have lights and sounds. I'm going to go ahead and kill one of my lights for sure. I may wind up killing the other one. If you look around the core, you do have four buttons. One is red, and I feel like the red one should be the weapon sound. It isn't. I think it's the tractor beam. So we're just going to go through them all. You're going to have little lights that pop up on the sail towers. So we're just going to go through them. Yeah, let's go ahead and kill the lights just a little bit. So that was the tractor beam. There's your docking sounds. You got your photon torpedoes, and I believe that's one is a phaser. And yeah, I mean, that's it. As much as I do love the Diamond Select ships that they gave us, Playmates did it better by giving buttons for individual sounds. Diamond Select, you have to cycle through all the sounds with one button. I like that if I want to role play, oh, the Enterprise is coming in, let's dock. Oh no, the Cardassians are attacking. Oh no, they brought the Dominion with them. Wait. There you go. Oh no, we got a damaged Klingon bird of prey. Let's bring him in for help. I hope it comes through just how loud this speaker is. It's very loud. But I love this. If you are a fan of Deep Space Nine, if you are just like collecting Star Trek ships in general, if you have the Hallmark ships, they'll be a little out of scale. They might look okay with this. I know Hallmark has their own Deep Space Nine ornament that I really want to get. A little expensive for my taste. I forgot where I was going with that. But if you want to get this thing, It is on eBay. They're not too expensive. I think out of box, you can find them for around 60, 70. In box, it varies from 90 up to 175. Some of them are still sealed. Just if you buy one loose, keep track of what is included. You should have 6 pylons. The ops tower should be attached to the shield generator already. There's a little enterprise that you need to have, and make sure all the battery covers are intact and there's no corrosion inside. Because again, this is a pretty old toy. Some people store their toys, the battery is still inside. But yeah, I love this. It's good to finally show this off in a video. If you do want to see some additional detailings for it, I'll go ahead and just kind of move the camera around. You can see, I mean, there's a lot there, but it's all repeated. So it's like once you see one section, once you see that, hey, guess what? It's the same over there. You're not missing much. There's the underside. If you want to see how that looks, you have a bunch of screws, but I don't mind that. So that is it for this video, guys and gals. I hope you have enjoyed this somewhat. I do have some more Star Trek videos planned. Get back on there. Some old, some new. We'll have to see. But I thank you for watching if you've made it this far. If you enjoyed it and you'd like to see more, you can subscribe to the top there. Be sure to hit that little bell so you know when I post new content. I've got 2 of my previous videos on the side there. Down below, I have a Patreon and YouTube membership. I got all my things behind the scenes looks, upcoming ideas, occasional bloopers, and our Discord server. I hope you all have a great day, and I will see you around. Take care.